Hey guys, welcome back. So we're about to dive into another episode of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. This is episode number 7 of Stardust Crusaders Strength. So we just watched episode 6, Dark Blue Moon, where we had the crew on a ship and they battled against a stand called Dark Blue Moon, who was water-based. So we had a bit of a sea battle with Jotaro taking on the bad guy, some sharks, met a new character by the name of Anne, a young stowaway. We thought it was a boy at the beginning and turns out that she's a girl. And then at the end, when the ship blows up, the crew escape in some lifeboats and they're about to be run down by a gigantic freighter. It's the recap. JoJo. Love it. So let's just dive right into this episode here. I sometimes like to make episode predictions about what I can expect in the next episode I'm about to watch. But when it comes to JoJo, I've got no friggin' idea. So there's a freighter. We're going to get JoJo and the team on board. And there's going to be some shenanigans. That's it. It's a really hot, windy day here in Sydney today. It didn't rain in the entire country yesterday. So the whole nation is on like very high fire danger alert. The wind is like howling a gale outside and it's like so hot. So I'm hoping everyone's safe out there today. I mean, it's very, very bad. But so the conditions for the bushfires is just optimal and the whole nation is on red alert. But you might hear some howling wind in the background. Not that that matters in like a state of emergency. You're going to hear a bit of background noise. So well, I just hope people are safe. But in any case, this is about JoJo right now and I'm going to sneeze. So without further ado, let's just dive into the next exciting episode of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, straight on Dio. Dio the Creepoid. We still haven't seen his face. Just standing around posing like he does. Who is this? Oh, the little old lady? Oh, there's always a battle. Why is he being so mysterious? Conquering fear is what it means to live. And there you are. Well, thank you very much, lady. Now the Joestars. Yep. No, because I kept kicking your ass. Gonna wipe him out again? Strength. So the little old witch lady is his counsel. Here comes the freighter. Oh shit. It's a big boat. I hear that music. I see the ending credits. I just smile. I smile. I can't help it. So Dio wants to take them on. He's got to take the Joestar family line out of his wheel of fortune. So, you know, the old adage, you can't get something done yourself. Do you do it yourself? I said it wrong. If you want something done, do it yourself. Yeah, just like Thanos. Yeah. Shut up. And just so you know, too, I feel like I got a bit of a sneeze coming on. I just had one brewing just before I started recording, and it went away. Don't you hate that? The sneezes that start coming and then they don't. I had one of those, so it's just loitering at the back of my nasal cavity. Sorry to be talking about cavities here and my JoJo reaction. But I hopefully don't sneeze halfway through this thing. Like I was mentioning with the hot wind, it's really kind of stirring up the dust and the pollens. Everybody's sneezing. Okay, so I would like to see Dio get into some episodes. Like, he's just been in the background. We haven't seen his face properly yet, which I don't understand, because we know who he is and what he looks like, unless he's had some massive cosmetic surgery. But I can't wait for him to get in on the action. So strength, that's going to be a stand. There's a lot of stand users running around. It's a ghost ship. Ghost ship. This show, anything can happen. There is a stand user, though. No, not a good idea. Where's the kid? Where's Anne? Is she here too? There she is. You can hear the creepy music. Okay. Whoa. Good grief. So that's his catchphrase. Why is everyone just standing around? Oh, very mysterious. What the... Of course. So the crew on the ship have been abandoned by the captain. Why have we got the... What is this? It's an orangutan. It's not a monkey. I've got a bad feeling about this. It's actually going for a pretty creepy vibe. It's like the Haunted House episode. Oh, they're the crew from the other ship. Right, okay. I thought they were crew from this ship, thinking there are people here. What's happening? But everyone has just got on board with... What? Goodness. Haven't had any in the show for a little while. It's a haunted ship. Nice. Come with me if you want to live. Nope. Hierophant green. This chick's freaking out. I'm out of here. Yes. Thank you. Something's gonna happen to the little girl. The orangutan's gonna bust out and start eating folk. That's the captain. Somebody turned him into an orangutan. Yeah, it's fresh. Oh, he's having a smoke. It is the captain. Okay. He's a human in there. So the orangutan's looking at Playboy and having a smoke. Okay, here comes Hierophant Green. What did he find? Nothing. Oh. Wi-Fi, man. I hate it when it doesn't connect. I know it's not Wi-Fi. This is really playing out like a horror movie. Young girl going off on her own. Having a shower. Something creepy gonna happen. Isn't she like 12? Right? Uh-oh. Oh shit. The crew is slaughtered. Comes a... The orangutan is out. And he likes little naked girls. We don't know who it is. Question mark. That orangutan was very creepy though. That was very disturbing. Playboy magazine? Oh, why are we loitering? This, she's a child? Stop it. Oh no. Oh no. I don't think she's a child. Wow, this is actually disturbing. Ha ha, good. You had that coming, creepy orangutan. Yeah, I was gonna say it's no ordinary orangutan. He's... Star Platinum. Come on! It's just what I was thinking as well. What is this? This is so good. This is awesome. Oh my God. He missed. You did. The mystery will reveal itself. I knew we were going to go into the freighter and have some shenanigans. Everybody's sinking into the ship. Wow, okay. Wait. The stand is the ship? Oh, this orangutan. He's got to go down. The ship is a stand? I got to learn the rules. Okay, so normal people can't see stands. Oh shit. Yes. Oh shit, getting crushed. You're in trouble. He is the captain. Strength. Ba-bang. Oh, he's got a little fruit Rubik's Cube. That's cool. This is so weird. Is he speaking? Oh no. What is Jodo doing? Oh, what? Just like in X-Men First Class. Good grief. Is that true? Yes, okay. Oh no! Punched the shit out of the orangutan. So if you stop the orangutan, let the ship just fall apart? Yeah, because the stand's not being constructed anymore. So the stand is disintegrating. So they've got, yeah, ghost ship. So still going to Singapore. 46 days left. Stand name, Strength. Ship. Okay. I'm rolling with it. So Dio sent the orangutan out there to kill them. Who, your son? My son's right arm shall take care of them all. Singapore. How long did they take to get to Singapore, though? They just kind of drifted aimlessly across the ocean for a few days. Don't ask tricky questions. Let's go with it. What is this thing? What? Hello? You're... Even when the show goes weird and goes off the rails, like it's want to do, I still love it so much. It's so quirky and strange. It just tickles me so well in all the right places. I'm not going to get any creepier than that. So now that we're in Singapore, what kind of other crazy shenanigans are we going to get up to now? That person, I think it was a person, or was it a doll? I don't know, sitting on the bed, asleep. That's going to be the next trouble a-brewing, I think. So these stands are very inventive. I didn't know a stand could be a ship, like a whole ship. So definitely got a lot to learn, but hey, this would have been a first for somebody, like all of you at one point, so you're going to learn as you go along with the show about what the rules are of stands, why one can be a ship, how an orangutan can be a stand user, and the orangutan was sent there by Dio, right? Strength. Stop there. So the little old lady who was giving Dio all the pointers and being his guardian and giving him all the advice, very creepy, and she said her son. Oh, was that her son on the bed at the end? His right arm will destroy them all, I think she said. So her son was there in Singapore waiting. I thought that she was implying that her son was part of the team and he was going to like do a double cross reveal or something. But no, her son was there waiting. Okay, because of short stature. I'm sure that's why they're related. I shouldn't discriminate. So another amazing episode. I do love that we're getting a bit more Dio in this one. I was so glad he came back, but they're just really holding him back right now. They're not doing any reveals, keeping his face in shadows. I love the build-up. It's just, well, we've got a long way to go, so I really appreciate they're taking their time with the story building. I mean, I guess that's why we do have a lot of episodes. I'm sure there's going to be like some episodes that feel like filler. This one kind of almost felt like a filler episode, but I'm still immensely entertained by it. Although I was a little bit confronted by the use of nudity with Anne. Like, isn't it implied that she's a small girl, like a child at this point? That she wasn't exactly drawn like a child, but as she's meant to be very young, right? And then it was kind of like weird and a little bit creepy watching her shower. And then the orangutan turned up and was just being all disgusting and weird as well, which is also like the ick factor went up somewhat. But I'm a little bit confused as to the character of Anne at this point. I mean, we were supposed to think that she was male at the beginning of the previous episode when we first introduced her character as the stowaway, like a little boy. But no, she's a little girl. But I don't think she's a little girl. I think she's going to be a bit more mature than what we think. I hope so. Because I don't want to feel icky. Anyway, that was amazing. I'm going to do a bit of a JoJo binge this afternoon. So I've got episode 8, The Devil, coming up very, very soon. So I'm hoping that you're enjoying my JoJo's dropping twice weekly, because Stardust Crusaders is so damn long and a lot of them are two-parters. I just thought that would be a great idea, and I know that you'd love it. Anyway, catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.